Good afternoon, everyone. My name's Nick Jacobs. My partner, Lee Turnbow, sick today, so we're flying solo here for the freshman quarterback. Some young players coming into the program against the defending national champs. They were undefeated last year, Morningside, and of course, the number one team in the country this year. Came out with a loss on the road, but finally back to the friendly confines here. And that doesn't mean there wasn't some good things to pick out from last year. Major Dedman, the freshman quarterback, did some nice things, threw some nice balls. We saw what he can do with his legs. We saw the emergence of RJ Williams as well. Some nice catches, six grabs for 66 yards as well. But let's welcome in the head coach for the University of St. Francis. And coach, I think what says the most about a team is once you get punched in the mouth is how do you respond. So can you tell us about how the week of practice was leading up to today?
Oh, it was great. And we just didn't get punched in the mouth. We got hammer fisted. You know, it, obviously very disappointing, embarrassing, quite frankly. But, you know, I told the team, you know, it counts as one. And you can't let one loss turn into two. And so the kids came back this week, and I thought we had a great week of practice. We revved up the intensity a little bit. Everybody was positive. And, you know, I told them that we needed to work on three things, and that makes us automatically better. We needed to work on lining up right on defense because we did not do that on last Saturday. We need to hold on to the football on offense, and we need to punt the damn ball. And if we do those three things, we're automatically better.
Well, you go from the number one team in the country to number three today, but at least it's a team you're familiar with. It's a team you played before that's in the conference. Is there anything that St. Francis does, St. Francis, Indiana does, that you guys can try to exploit?
Well, you know, they're a good program and a good team. You know, offensively, they got a real good quarterback. When we saw him last year, you know, I think he was in his first start, and they really weren't using him all that much. He threw the ball, but as the season went along, they utilized him in the running game and the throwing game and everything else. So I think he's going to be a handful today, and he's got some great receivers on the outside. So for us, defensively, we just have to line up right and read our keys and swarm to the ball and stay on our feet and tackle. And I think tackling, obviously the first game, tackling wasn't very good for us on defense either. So hopefully we improve on that today. On the other side of the ball, them defensively, you know, with last week being Major's first start, you know, we tried to, you know, put on kid's gloves, so to speak, and tried not to put him in any stressful kind of situations. Well, you know, we're opening it up a little bit more with him today. We're still putting the ball in his hands. Everything on our offense is going to run through, you know, him technically, and, you know, be able to get the ball to Michael and Dwayne and Brandon and some of our other guys on offense, RJ, you know, I think it'll be big today.
There was some discussion last week, you know, once you were down big later in the game, do you stick with Major Dedman? Do you keep Major Dedman, the freshman quarterback, true freshman out of Freeport. So many awards from the media in his high school days, and we're happy to have him here as a member of the Saints. Again, a pretty tough opening two games for a true freshman quarterback. He'll have some nice skill positions to get the ball to, though. Dwayne Milton, over 1,000 yards, setting the school rushing record last year, a senior out of McChesney Park. Wide receivers are Mike Johnson, Brandon Ruffin, Daniel Getch, the freshman out of West Chicago, and of course Brandon Ruffin, the best receiver ever to come through St. Francis, and he's just getting into his senior year out of Peoria High School. 50 catches, nearly 1,000 yards, 14 touchdowns last year, an All-American honorable mention as well. A punter, Gavin Gardner as well, or the kickoff rather here from Gavin Gardner. And we'll see Major Dedman, his first action here at Memorial Stadium as Justin Bruns lets that go out of the back of the end zone. Wishing our friend Lee Turnbow a quick recovery here. He was out sick today. Gonna miss Lee here today, but hopefully he'll be back for the next home game for the Saints, which won't be for a while. October 5th is the next home game against Robert Morris. Three road games in a row after this one. Here we go. Major Dedman is the quarterback. He'll be in the pistol with Dwayne Milton right behind him. Three wide receivers off to the right. One to the left. There's the snap, and it is going to be an option. They hand off to Milton. He'll pick up 1 yard on the play up to the 26-yard line. Dwayne Milton stymied last week. Just 9 touches for 17 yards after 1,089 last year. Of course, the Saints, they have the consensus toughest schedule in the country. That's pretty much according to anybody you talk to. Quick screen out left side. The ball into the hands of Milton. Some nice blocking outside by Ruffin. Gives him the sideline up past the 50 into Cougar territory. And a big first down for the Saints. Great blocking on the outside by number 80, Brandon Ruffin. He's a track athlete. He's got major, major speed, but he's not afraid to mix it up in the run game or in that quick passing game as well when his blocks are needed. Nicely done there. Dwayne Milton, the big pickup up to the 49 of the Cougars. Dwayne Milton, the transfer from Northern Illinois University last year. Mike Johnson in motion. Turn, give, Dwayne Milton again, trying to break a tackle, stays on his feet and fights past the 45 up to about the 43, 44 yard line or so, a pickup of 5 on first down. So welcome everyone tuning in, whether you're listening on WCFF 88.7 here in the Joliet area, maybe you're out in Fort Wayne watching on our YouTube or Facebook channels, and we're going to have a free play here for the Saints. Dedman fires off to the right side, it's incomplete. Looking for Getch on the outside. We do have a flag on the play. That is going to be offsides on the left tackle for St. Francis of Indiana. I should say the defensive end, pardon me. We'll get the official call here from our referee. I believe it was Jamisich on the outside, James Jamisich, which is good. That guy, he is a scary, scary presence on the defensive line for University of St. Francis, Indiana. Senior from Fort Wayne, homegrown guy, 53 tackles, 13 sacks last year. 14 and a half tackles behind the line. He is a force coming off the edge for the Cougars, and we're going to have to keep an eye on him. I imagine he will be double-teamed. Give again, inside run for Milton, still on his feet. Squirts past the 35 up to the 34. A pickup of about 4 yards on the play. We say 4 yards on the play. Second down and 6. They need to get to the 28 for a first down. And there you see Dedman, number 7. Milton, number 1. In the backfield, motion again from Johnson. They give it to Mike on the sweep, turns it upfield past the 30, spins his way for another yard or two, and it's going to be close to a first down. Depends on the spot, and the official gives him the signal. First down for the Saints, 2 first downs on their opening drive here, their home opener against the number 3 team in the country. Nice carry by Mike Johnson, a running back by trade, but they line him up pretty much anywhere on the field. And we're going to have a stacked diamond set on the outside here for Major Dedman, all alone in the backfield. The true freshman, Brandon Ruffin, left side. He's going to be all alone. And Dedman takes it himself, picks up about 2 yards. I will take Brandon Ruffin in one-on-one coverage against any cornerback in the country. Big frame on the outside, 6'4", 180 pounds. Not only is he a sprinter, but a jumper as well on the track and field team. They're going to throw to Brandon, bubble screen, incomplete pass. A little bit tall, even for Brandon on the play. It's going to bring up 3rd down and 7. Hurrying up to the line, the tight end is going to be Malik Roberts on the right side. Getch now left side. R.J. Williams had a nice game last week. He'll be wide right with Brandon Ruffin in the... It's going to bring up 3rd down and 9. But this offense is very capable of picking up chunks of 8, 9, 10 yards at a time with Matt Crable as their quarterback and two senior wide receivers leading the way. Nice hit by that man, Mike Grubin. Two tackles in a row, that one behind the line. First third down of the game for the Cougars. 8:43 to go in the first quarter. Crable looking, has to roll out of the pocket and sees some daylight. He's going to run it himself for a first down up to the 38-yard line before he is upended by the safety coming in to make the stop, John Pullen, freshman safety out of Joliet West. Matt Crable, not a one-trick pony. He's got a great arm, but if he needs to tuck it and run, well, you just saw he is very capable of doing so. 14-yard pickup by Matt Crable. That would have been a nice momentum shifter to stop him on third down, but that's why this offense was the second best in the conference last year. Crable again to throw. Plenty of time. Find someone in the middle of the field. Rixey makes one man miss, but Grubin there to clean it up at the 25-yard line. That's a 14-yard, maybe make it 15-yard pass play. And another first down for the Cougars. Dan Rixey's second grab of the game. He'll take a breather here. Dylan Hunley, the junior wide receiver, will come in. And you just saw all the time that the offensive line gave him on that first down run. Plenty of room as the safeties were dropping back into coverage. Crable noticed the space and took advantage. Again, that formation. Martell Williams, the tailback this time. He'll get the carry. Met near the line of scrimmage, making the tackle for the Saints. John pulling the safety, but he did pick up 5 after the lunge at the end. Up to the 20-yard line, 7:20 to go first quarter. It's 7-0, the Cougars of St. Francis. You see, USF versus USF. First carry here for Williams. Nice tackle by Pullen. 39, John Pullen, the freshman from Joliet West. Two-time all-conference defender in high school. Blitz being shown, left to the quarterback. They bring some heat, they lob it into the end zone and up and knocked away. A beautiful play by St. Francis defense. The defender there on the outside to knock it away from the intended receiver, Hunley. Hathon Hurdle there to knock it away from his quarterback spot. Returning starter from Lockport. See it here. He pretty much was looking at the receiver the entire way. The receiver put his hands up. Hurdle put his hands right in between them. Knocked it away. Beautiful play by Hathon. See the GG sticker. Gordy lines of the helmets here for the new helmets, I believe, for the Saints. Dean back in at tailback. It'll be Crable on the run. Fire into the end zone again. Puts a little mustard on it, but a little bit too tall for his intended receiver, Rocky James, out of Zena, Ohio. And that brings up fourth down. We'll see if they go for it here, if they want to kick it, kick the field goal. Crable close to the sideline there. And he's going to come back on the field. Looks like the Cougars are going to go for it here on fourth down and 6 at the 20-yard line of the Saints. I imagine they're just going to go into a play that they've been running every single day here in the offseason, something safe that they know they could pick up a good 5 or 6 yards. Let's see if the Saints can stop them here on fourth down, firing across the middle, and it is a catch at the 5. What concentration by Rocky James. It was thrown behind him. He tipped it to himself and was able to corral it for a first down. It's first and goal for the Cougars. You'll see it again here on the crossing route. A little bit behind him, not the best throw, but Rocky James with some great concentration gives his team a first down and goal at the 5. James, that senior out of Ohio, had 62 catches and 7 touchdowns last year. Was their best receiver. No surprise they went to him on fourth down. Dean the tailback. It's going to be a run for Crable. He's upended right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing doing there. Nice Stop pulling again among the tacklers, along with Mason DeLong, the linebacker. It's 47, Mason DeLong, the junior from Bradley Bourbonnais. A couple interceptions last year, a forced fumble, four sacks. Second team all-conference player, Mason DeLong. Wing back on the left side here for the Cougars. Again, tailback is Dean. Two wide receivers off to the left. Motion man to the right. They're going to throw right to him, and it's a touchdown in the corner of the end zone. Going to the man in motion. Casey Cole, the junior, getting his first start of his career. Only had a couple of catches last year, but put six more on the board here for the Cougars. A well-designed play. And again, Gardner on to kick the extra points. It's up and it is good. It is 14-0, 5:20 to go here in the first quarter, Saints home opener. We're going to see that freshman quarterback again for the second offensive possession for the Saints. Back to return the kick will be Bruns and Ruffin, as you see the kicker Gardner trot off the field after putting that one through. Name of the game here for the Saints for me is just trying to get the football into the hands of the playmaker, something they were not able to do last week against the number one team in the country. Ruffin with only one catch for 30 yards. Dwayne Milton, the record-breaking running back for the Saints, just 9 carries for 17. The drive goes 12 plays and 64 yards for St. Francis, Indiana. Took nearly 6 minutes off the clock. Sitting between the goal line and the 5, ready to return it. Matt Crable so far on the game for 73 yards and 2 touchdowns. They've had great field position. It will be Bruns from the 6. Up Marks Ruffin with a block. Won't get much past the 24-25 yard line before he stood up. See the golden spikes there of Paray Barberin, one of the reserve running backs. Always fashionable, Paray is. It was an interesting conversation last week against Morningside. You were down by such a margin that the game wasn't really in question in the second half. So the question was, in regards to Major Dedman, right there, the true freshman quarterback, do you keep him in against the number one team in the country, let him get his reps, or do you take him out and preserve him? My opinion, which happened to be Coach Curry's opinion as well, is he's a quarterback, he needs the reps, go get him, son. And he played the rest of the game. Milton on the sweep. Jackson again, I believe his second tackle of the game. Third down here and six for the Saints. 2:40 to go, first quarter. Looking his way, looking downfield, looking deep for Ruffin. They had him, but he couldn't hold on at the 10-yard line. Incomplete. Incomplete. He does not drop those balls very often. It was Ryan Johnson, the senior corner, on the defense for the play for the Cougars. Fourth down, and they're going to have to punt it away. You'll see it again. That was right on the money. What a throw by Denman. Led him just enough. It might have been a little bit of contact just a bit early on that play, but not enough to bring out the flags. Incomplete. I'm sure Brandon Ruffin wants that one back. Fourth down, and here is the punt from Holberry. Down the right hash, it'll be fair caught at the 19-yard line. Good punt by Josh Holberry that time. Had to punt it 9 times last week. Fair caught by number 5, Dylan Hunting. St. Francis, Indiana, will take over at its own 19-yard line. Defense spent a lot of time on the field last week. Major Denman was 13 for 28 with a pick, only 158 yards. Was also the team rusher, 22 attempts for just 61 yards. Here's Crable to throw. Looking, plenty of time. Finally, the pocket collapses. He'll roll right fire to his receiver. Coming ball at the 30. It looks to be enough for the first down to Dan Rixey again. Crable pass complete to number 7, Dan Rixey. He was pushed out of bounds by number 20, Jalen Cooper. Rixey's third catch for over 35 yards now as we wind down the final 2 minutes of quarter number one here in Joliet. Home opener for the Saints football team, their 33rd year of football here at St. Francis. Crable turns, gives. I believe it's Williams between the guard and the tackle. Well, maybe a yard there. Martell Williams carried the ball 45 times last year, just 238 yards. Yards, 4 touchdowns. It was all about P.J. Dean, the starting tailback. Justin Green, I believe, was their tailback in those 2 championship years. He went down with an injury last year, pushing P.J. Dean into that starting spot where he has excelled. Here comes the blitz by the Saints, and wide open is Rixey again. Cuts back at the 45-yard line. That's enough for a first down, a pickup of 15 yards on the pitch and catch. Rixey is just finding every hole in that defense. And Crable knows where he is every single time, and he's throwing darts right at him. Gain of 15 on the pass play. First down, St. Francis, Indiana. See if St. Francis tries to bring the heat again or if they try to fill up some of those holes in the passing game for the Cougars. They are going to bring the blitz from the linebacker. They run right at the blitz, but tough run by P.J. Dean up near midfield. He'll pick up 5. You saw the jersey being held back, but he fought through that and tried to flatten the defender here at the end. Take another look. Finds the hole, gets back the blitzer, but that was Mason DeLong getting a handful of P.J. Dean's jersey before he runs over Jalen Cooper, the cornerback for the Saints, and that'll bring us to the end of quarter number one. It's 14-0. The Cougars on top of the Saints in the Battle of St. Francis here in Joliet. We'll be back right after this for quarter number two. You're watching Saints football on the Saints TV network.
It's our conference meet, so it's kind of our biggest meet of the year. Sharon was a Lindsey Wilson runner. We'd known each other for a long time, and she is a sweetheart. She's absolutely adorable. You would never want anything bad to happen to her in a race, ever.
And we were 2.5 miles into it, and Darcy and I were in second and third, and Sharon was in first. We knew that she had gone the wrong way, because we could barely still see her. She was still pretty far in front of us.
She still came in third place at the finish, but I came in first and Danielle came in second. Immediately, we just go, no! We both literally did this motion with our arms.
We didn't want the credit for first and second because we knew that's not what it really was.
Well, I'm very proud of our girls. You know, you can't help but be proud. Anytime someone does the right thing, no matter what. In our day and age now, it's everybody out for themselves mostly. And I think it's just, we're teaching the kids the wrong thing when we do something like that. We need to teach them, yeah, you want to win. You want to be the best. You should strive to break a record. But remember, you know, the lifestyle you live is the most important thing of all.
Welcome back to Joliet, quarter number two, ready to get underway here. 14-0 St. Francis Cougars on top of St. Francis Saints here on the home opener for the Saints. It is second down and 5 as we pick up the action ball on the 50-yard line. We'll get quarter number one stats here in just a minute. Matt Crable in that pistol, P.J. Dean, play action. Crable rolling right, checks it down, and another first down past the 40-yard line. He finds Devin Green, his wing back, a senior out of Bloomington, Indiana. I believe he was a defender, played 13 games last year on the defensive side of the ball before they moved him over onto the offensive side. He picks up the first down. Another shallow crossing route by the wing back for the first down on that play. You see the variety that the Cougars offense provides. They come at you from a lot of different directions. First down here to Crable. They snapped it. I don't think the offense was ready. Crable on the run and still able to pick up a few yards on the play. Nobody was ready for that one, offense or defense. Center snapped the ball without anybody being ready. Nick Shoemaker, the senior center. Again, the athleticism of Crable. He really just fell into the back pockets of St. Francis, Indiana after Nick Ferrer graduated. He came in as a transfer from Grand Valley University. And he'll give to Dean. Tough run near the 30-yard line. He'll pick up about 5. It should be about 3rd and 2 now for the Cougars of St. Francis, Indiana. In that first quarter. So take a look at that again. 7 rushing yards for Indiana and 5 for St. Francis of Joliet. 98 passing yards, though, for the Cougars, just 34 for the Saints. 17 plays, 121 yards in the first quarter alone for Indiana, 16 for 62 for the Saints. Third down and 3 for Crable and the Cougars. Quick pass, screen left. It's going to be a race up to the edge near the 20, and another first down. This one to Jordan Schmeling, his first catch of the afternoon. Caught 14 passes last year for 180 yards. Didn't see the end zone. But you can see why with the amount of talent they have at wide receiver and the amount of talent they have coming back this year at wide receiver. Cody Randa able to track him down at the sideline at the 23-yard line. First down and 10 again. Here for the USF Cougars. Here's Crable, looking end zone, splits the defenders and diving in past the goal line. It is a touchdown. Will Chrisman, his first catch of the afternoon, is a touchdown. What a weapon he is as well. Huge frame, 6'6", 241. And Crable threw a beautiful ball right between the corner and the safety for the touchdown. Saw it again there as he sneaks it into the pylon. Hurdle, along with John Poland for the Saints. We're there at the end. 9 plays, 81 yards for St. Francis, Indiana. Took about 4.5 minutes off the clock. There's Coach Curry talking to Hathon Hurdle, the cornerback, explaining to him some finer points of how to protect that pass on the outside. So far, the Saints have been quiet offensively. Just 2 for 4 through the air for 34 yards. Milton and Ruffin were the two receivers on those two passes. On the ground, carried it 5 times. Mike Johnson had a carry for 6. Major Denman's carried it 6 times for 6 yards. Justin Bruns sitting back ready to return the kick. Don't believe that is Brandon Ruffin to return on the outside. On the left-hand side of the return, we'll see where it goes here from the kick from Gavin Gardner. It'll be a short kick to the 31-yard line. Not much room to return it, and that is where the Saints offense will start. Right at the 31, 12.5 to go here in the first half. It's 21-0 Cougars in their opening game of the season. They've won the last 19 season openers. They've only been around for 22 years. The last loss on a season opener for the Cougars of St. Francis was 1999 when they lost 35-6 to Valparaiso. Ever since then, they've owned opening day. Milton in motion from a wide receiver spot. Denman decided to keep it. Didn't fool any of the Cougars. He'll go back for a loss. Up off the bottom of that pile, James Jamisic, their stud defensive end. It's Brandon Ruffin, record-setting wide receiver last year. 50 catches, 916, and 14 touchdowns. The career leader here at USF in yards and touchdowns in just 3 years. Here's second down and 11. Denman's going to have to throw this time. Steps up in the pocket. Tries to run it again. Gets it back up to the 35. He picks up 5 on the play. It's going to be third down and 6 for the Saints. Eleven and a half to go. Major Dedman, the true freshman out of Freeport in the Rockford area. There's his drop. Pressure coming up the middle through incomplete right through the hands of R.J. Williams. Probably would have picked up the first down if he were able to corral that. It was a bit high, but he did get 2 hands on it. That's going to bring up fourth down, though, and the Saints again will have to punt it away. Tyler Keene out there to punt it this time. Your starting punter was Josh Holberry, but Keene's going to get a crack at it here with 11:19 to go. There's Tyler. Takes the face-high snap. Short punt, though. That's going to be still on the same issue here the first 2 weeks, for sure. St. Francis, Indiana, will take over at the Fighting Saints 49-yard line. There's one thing you don't need to do, it's give these Cougars this offense any kind of a short field, and they're going to have it at the Saint 49 here. See if we can dial up something on defense here to get at that quarterback. Crable has had all the time he needs. to throw the ball. He's going to roll to his left this time. Some pressure there, but gets rid of it quickly into the hands of James. And close to the first down at the 40-yard line. They give him the 41, it appears, which would be enough for a first down. It is 10 yards out to Rocky James. The Hathon Hurdles side, one of the returning corners for the Saints. You see Rocky, another senior wide receiver. Three wide outs this time. Tailback is Williams. They're going to throw it right down the middle, right to their tight end fullback. He's upended at the 15-yard line. Casey Cole again. He caught the touchdown earlier in the first quarter, and he was wide open up the middle. That was an RPO there for Crable. Could have handed it off to Williams, but he saw Cole wide open on a seam route and picked it up, and now they're into the red zone again at the 14-yard line. First and 10. Sunny 78-degree day here, a beautiful day. As Crable turns and gives it to Williams. Hit at the line, and the run defense has been there for the Saints. It has been stout. They haven't been able to slow down the passing attack, but Blake Evans there, the linebacker, transfer out of Concordia St. Paul up in Minnesota. He is a local kid out of Lincoln Way West. Excited to see what he can do in that linebacker core. He led his Division II team in tackles a few years ago. Had the ninth all-time tackle total in one season at Concordia St. Paul. He's transferred here now. 1 yard gain, second and 9. Throwing into the end zone, it's James, and it's a jump ball, and he comes down with it again. Hathon Hurdle beat in the end zone, and he was just outsized by Rocky James. Nine and a half to go, makes it 27. Extra point will make it 28-0 here. If Gavin Gardner can put it through, and he has the previous three times. See it again. Hathon Hurdle had the right position, just Rocky James, too big and too good of an athlete. Kick on the way, and that one's good as well. 28-0, nine and a half to go here in Joliet. 9.5 minutes to go till halftime. St. Francis, Indiana, tell you what, the Saints aren't the only one to get this kind of a treatment. They are 15-0 in their last 15 games against Illinois teams. Straight wins against teams. You cannot overstate the tough schedule that the Saints have this year. It really is kind of front-loaded, too, with Morningside to start the year. St. Francis, Indiana, today. They're on the road at Trinity International next week before they take on the number 6 team in the country on the road at Concordia, Michigan. And then they got St. Xavier, the number 5 team in the country, twice. A lot of teams lost a game because Lindenwood Belleville suspended their athletics program. It's just one of the lucky ones to still play a game, although it's just going to be against St. Xavier again. One's going to be a conference game, one's going to be a non-conference game, as the kickoff will be sent deep to the end zone for the touchback. The two games will be October 26th, and then it'll finish the regular season on November 16th. That will be the conference game, the final game of the year, at home here in Joliet. As far as St. Francis goes, their game against Lindenwood Belleville was going to be a home game, but they lost that game and were unable to find a replacement game. Low snap here to Major Denman. Here comes pressure. Steps up, looking long, looking deep for Williams, and just a bit overthrown into double coverage. Would have had to have been an amazing play by RJ to come down with it. Saw a little arm strength there, though, by Major Dedman. And a 40-yard pass through the air by the true freshman. Got to take your shots, though. I know you want to be safe, as Coach Curry put it, put the kids' gloves on him here in the first, just his second start of his college career. But you also have to try to make something happen here as he hands off. See who the ball carrier was. It was Mike Johnson. No gain. Brings up third down. 9:12 to go here in the second quarter.
Michael Johnson with the carry.
R.J. Williams, number four, was a contributor his freshman year 2 years ago, but then he was injured last year, didn't play at all. As Dedmon takes off, and he's got the first down marker and more up the sideline past the 50-yard line. That's going to go for about 36, almost 40 yards on the quarterback keeper for Major Dedmon.
35-yard
I believe that's the longest play of the season so far for the Saints. Don't forget, you can stream all 2019 USF home football games live online through the USF YouTube channel. As you see, Major Dedmon turn on the afterburners here, and a nice block on the outside again. Brandon Ruffin in among the blockers as the first down play goes for about no gain into the St. Francis, Indiana bench. Mike Johnson, the ball carrier. Watch all of our home football games live on the USF YouTube channel. Just go to GoFightingSaints.com, click on upcoming events, and you'll see the video link right next to the game you want to watch. USF sports fans can also catch home soccer and volleyball matches online this fall, too. Here's Dedmon to throw. Looking for Malik Roberts, his big tight end, and not a lot of room up to the 43-yard line, so they give him about 4 yards in the play and brings up fourth down. Ryan Johnson on the stop. I'd love to see more Malik Roberts. Big guy, 6'4", 250 out of Naperville Central. Just a big target on the outside as you see him take his spot on the right side. And we will have a timeout called by the Cougars. With 7:55 to go here in the first half, it's 28-0 St. Francis, Indiana. The Saints still looking for their first points of the season, but again, man, the schedule. You play the last three national champions. Morningside last year and St. Francis the 2 years before that. As you hear our athletic director and my partner on away games on the radio, Dave Laqueta, mentioned soccer won earlier today. Immediately before this game, a 1-0 victory. And just look at this conference. The MSFA is just incredible. And there's no question it's the toughest conference in the country, with St. Francis, Indiana, St. Xavier, Concordia, Marion, all in the top seven. Now, they don't have four teams in the top 25. They have four teams in the top seven. Olivet Nazarene also receiving some votes. Pretty incredible conference that St. Francis has to try to fight their way through. Third down and seven for St. Francis. Dedmon in the shotgun. We have Ruffin on the slot right. Firing, looking, and Malik Roberts wide open makes the catch up to the 15-yard line. 30 yards on the pitch and catch to Malik Roberts. Right on time, Mr. Roberts. Into the red zone for the first time this season. See, again, there's flashes of what Major Dedmon can do. He put that one right on the money. Little bobble there at the end, and that was the knock on Malik Roberts last year, was he dropped balls he should have caught, but he was able to hang on to that one. Option play, but they read it perfectly. Dedmon going nowhere. He'll lose two. Again, it's James Jamisich. They're all-world defensive end.
Loss of three on the play. Second and 13 for the Saints.
Second and 13, back to the 17-yard line. 7 minutes even to go here in the first half. Look for Ruffin here. He's split wide right. He'll be single. Thought they were in a double team, but they left him alone. But it was an inside run back to the original line of scrimmage. So third down and 10. Mike Johnson again, the carry. But you got to throw it up here to Ruffin.
Michael Johnson with the carry. Tackle number 56, Jamal Jackson. Pick up a three on the play.
So you got the two big targets in the red zone on the right side here. Ruffin in the slot, Malik Roberts wide right. There's Malik. Snap, Deadman looking. And pocket collapses again. He can't escape. Back to the 22-yard line. It's a loss of 7 on the quarterback sack, and they just get after it. Was that Jamisich again? It was. Again, he was in on it. Again, 13 sacks last season alone, 14 and a half tackles behind the line. He is a monster at defensive end, a senior homegrown product out of Fort Wayne. You'll see it again. Jamisich just dispatches his man and gets to the quarterback. And that's no slouch there at right. That's an all-conference right tackle. Zach Bikema right there. Jamisich just too big, too strong. They're going to let this one tick down. Looks like they might take a timeout before they see if they attempt a field goal here on fourth down. The field goal would end up being what? Let's see. At the 24-yard line. So you're talking about a 40-yard field goal. Maybe 41 is the timeout it's taken with 5.5 to go. So timeout taken. Saints looking for their first points of the season. There's Coach Curry. He sent Holberry out there to try to get a big boot or try to throw it up into the end zone again. That's what you do. I mean, if you're going to run a fourth down play, the first down marker is at the 4. You just throw it into the end zone and hope Ruffin or Roberts can get under it and make a play. But what that requires is time. And the Cougars know that, so you know that Jamison and company are going to pin their ears back and try to get after Deadman, which they have been able to do a few times so far today. This is the fifth meeting between the two St. Francis schools. Cougars 4-0 in the previous four. Winning by an average of 26.5 points a game. Last meeting was last year to open up the season. 49-14 win for the Cougars. And they will go for it here on fourth down and 19. Snap to Major. Just give him a little bit of time. And it's knocked out of his hands. And it is... I'm not sure if they're going to say an interception or a fumble, but it was taken away. I believe it was Jamisich who knocked it away. Matt Schwartz, the nose tackle there to essentially just have the ball bounce right to him. The Cougars winning in the trenches here, and they got to Major Deadman again as he was about to throw. Knocked out of his hands right to the nose tackle, who had the presence of mind to grab it. And the Cougars take over at their own 35-yard line. Crable and company taking over at their own 35. First down. Hurdle coming up to jam his man. It is a sack, first sack of the game for St. Francis. Nice defensive effort there. Jake Pott, the defensive end, among the tacklers. Big Jake Pott out of Lincoln Way Central, a redshirt freshman from New Lenox. Played a couple games last year before he was injured and redshirted. Clock ticks under 5 minutes here in the first half. Safety's way back in midfield. See if they bring any pressure again. Nope, three-man rush for the Saints, but he breaks through. Nose tackle is there, forcing Crable to run. He throws on the run and incomplete. that Chris Peters who got, nope, I take that back. It was Mike Falachek who broke through the line to get the quarterback hurry on Crable. Falachek, the junior starter, nose tackle out of Manhattan, a Providence Catholic product. Started all 11 games last year. Started both games this year. Four and a half to go. Clock stops after the incomplete pass. It is third down and 14 to go at the 31-yard line for that man, Matt Crable. Down the middle of the field. Seam route again is incomplete. Looking again for Casey Cole. They hit on that play a few times already today, but John Pullen saw that one coming, was able to defend nicely, and will force the first punt of the season for the opponent. Justin Bruns will be the return man. Good defensive effort by John Pullen there. The rest of his defensive unit. Snap, bit high, handled, punt is away. Spiral punt, it will bounce at the 25 and it takes a beautiful Cougar hop inside the 15-yard line. Nothing Bruns can do with that one. Major Denman will take over with his offensive squad at about, we'll see where they mark it down, the 12-yard line. Beautiful punt. St. Francis, Indiana. The punter, Joe Knepper, a senior, another homegrown product out of Fort Wayne. Coach Kevin Donnelly for the St. Francis Cougars. 22 years he started this program, and all he's done is go 212-47. Incredible. Here's Deadman on the quarterback draw. No room that time. It looked like the nose tackle again, Matt Swartz, might have got a handful. St. Francis, Indiana came out with a ball, but they're not going to say it was a turnover. It's going to be a loss of three, second down and 13, 4 minutes and counting here in the first half. So Kevin Donnelly, 212-47 in his 22 years at St. Francis, Indiana. It is his 41st year of coaching. 326 wins to just 132 losses and a tie. As Deadman hands off to Johnson on the sweep, he finds the edge and some room. There goes Mike Johnson racing past the 50, caught up at about the 43-yard line. On a 55-yard run for Mike Johnson. Now that's the biggest play of the season. Any flags? I don't see him. I see Mike Johnson here. Gets the edge. Who gets the key block on the outside? Ruffin springs him at the end there before he's tracked down. Looks like they might put him at the 45-yard line, but there was a flag. That's what sprung him, the holding at the 22-yard line. So the hold, 10 yards down the field, marks the ball at the original line of scrimmage. If that hasn't been a microcosm of the first week and a half, I don't know what is. See if we can pick up the hold here on the outside. Must have been off our screen because there was nothing there. Oh, that's a backbreaker for the Saints right there. Major Denman with a ripped jersey. You can see his shoulder pads and chest protector. I'm not sure if they're going to let him play like that. Saints take their second timeout. 3:19 to go. I don't think I've ever seen that before. It's like Superman ripped open his suit to expose the costume under his chest. It'll be second down and 10 when the play resumes. Just a backbreaker. That was about 50 yards on the run by Mike Johnson on the sweep before it was called back due to that penalty. Can't keep shooting yourselves in the foot, though. Some opportunities have been there against the Cougars. And we've had a couple of plays called back because of those penalties. So back to Coach Connolly for the Cougars. 41 years coaching. Collegiate coach going right now. Any level. NAIA, D1, 2, and 3. Your Nick Sabans of the world? Nope. 326 wins for Kevin Donnelly. Seventh all-time. Not just actively, but if you'd look at all-time collegiate coaching, he is the seventh most wins. He just passed Bear Bryant with his quarterfinal victory last year. If that gives you an idea, there he is, Kevin Donnelly. When you're in Bear Bryant company, you know you're doing something right. Of course, he's number one in NAIA history. Deadman will keep it on the fake. Dancing his way past the 20 to the 25, wrapped up down to the 29-yard line, and a 19-yard gain and a first down. Major Denman has been the player of the game so far for the Saints. 3-10 and counting as soon as the sticks reset. First down up to the 29-yard line. Saints been moving the football here. Motion man is Johnson. They give it to him on the sweep, but they're going to blow it dead here. The penalty flag, another penalty on the Saints. Ugh. They're going to attack Zach Bikema on the false start. The all-conference right tackle for the Saints. A 17-yard carry for Major Deadman right now, rushing 14 carries for 31 yards. Five-yard penalty makes it first down and 15 back at the 24-yard line. Pitch over to Dwayne Milton. Contact near the 30. Knocking him out of bounds was Ryan Johnson, the corner again. And another flag coming in, and we're going to have a taunting penalty on the Saints bench.
Penalty on the field after the play.
Now, officials are going to talk about it, but that was what the penalty was for. I saw exactly what happened. One of the players who's not even dressing kind of clapped and yelled. It didn't seem too egregious, to be honest, but they're going to get an unsportsmanlike conduct flag on it. Wait, it can't be an automatic first down because it's on the Saints. Still early in the season for the officials, too. I believe it's just a 15-yard penalty here. As it sits, it's first and 15. I think it was on the Saints anyway. They haven't really marked it off one way or another. Here we go, we'll get another explanation. So half the distance to the goal now instead of the automatic first down. So that marks the ball at the 11-yard line. We'll make it the 12. About 29 yards to go here on second down. Second down and 29, I believe. Denman will be in the shotgun right next to Milton. I guess swing it over to Dwayne. Gets a block, but a nice tackle. Shoestring tackle by Ryan Johnson. We have called his name a lot. Ryan Johnson doing the job for St. Francis, Indiana. Nick Lucas and Ethan Thurr so far lead the tacklers for the Cougars, 7 and 5 respectively. But that, I believe, is the fifth tackle for Ryan Johnson. He'll see it again here. I thought he was going to break it. I thought Dwayne, but one hand got the knee, and down he went. Third down. Looks like they're going to say 24 yards now after the carry. 100 seconds left. But another timeout is called by the Saints. Kevin Donnelly, the head coach for the Cougars, like we mentioned, he's a all-time winningest active collegiate coach, seventh all-time, just passing Bear Bryant, number one in NAIA history. He's the four-time NAIA Coach of the Year, 20 consecutive winning seasons. Was elected to the NAIA Hall of Fame back in 2013. His road started at Anderson College of Indiana, his alma mater, Brown College, and then over to California University, Pennsylvania, not California on the West Coast, but California University in Pennsylvania, before he started the program at St. Francis, Indiana, 22 years ago. And all he's done since then is win 212 games and have the field named after him. Donnelly Field at Darcy Stadium over there in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Pretty good crowd out here for the home opener for the Saints. Nice crowd here on the home side. And you'll even see some blue shirts on this side because, well, the other side, they're just getting baked by the sun. So some of the Cougars fans decided to mosey on over here and take a seat with the Saints, who have been nothing but friendly, I'm sure. As you see the Cougars fans, some of them don't mind getting a little late summer tan. Here we go, 1:36 to go, third down in about a mile. They hand off to Dwayne Milton. They'll push up to the 25-yard line, still about 4 yards or 3 yards shy of the original line of scrimmage. So it's going to be fourth down and 13. Number timeout called on the field, I think this time by the Cougars. St. Francis going with that true freshman. They had a real good quarterback competition in the offseason between Major Dedman, who obviously got the nod, and his backup, Jamal Salam, who's a junior. He is a junior and a junior college transfer as well out of West Hills College in Hanford, California. Had a 4-6 record at West Hills College in 10 games. It's 54% through the air, 2,800 yards, 22 touchdowns, and 12 picks. He can run too, 55 rushes. Much more comfortable in the pocket as a passer, Major Dedman with the week, but a lot of pretty good things this week as well, both through the air and with his legs especially. It was the first time that Coach Curry has had to deal with that type of situation, a quarterback competition. In his 8 years at the helm of the Saints, it's the first time the starting quarterback to start the year was not on the roster the year before. If you look through the starting quarterbacks, from 2010, it was E.J. White. He started as a freshman. And that was the last time the Saints had a starting quarterback that wasn't on the roster the year before. E.J. White, who came in as a freshman, he started all 4 years. Trace Wanless took over in
27.
And then Donnie Butkus took over in 2015. He started all 4 years. Let's see if we can get a good punt off here. Decent punt. Return will start from the 37-yard line. He tripped and fell, though, as he tried to kick it into gear, though. The return man, Matt Komunkevich, a junior out of Mishawaka, Indiana. Just look at the list of quarterbacks St. Francis, Illinois have, your Saints. Just been blessed ever since about 2006. John Goolsbee came in as a freshman, set a bunch of records in his time from 2006 to 2008. Then E.J. White takes over in 2010. He resets the record books. Trace Wanless has a year in there before Donnie Butkus was ready to go in 2015. And he started for 4 years. Now they have to start again here with Major Dedman. Here's Crable to throw for the Cougars. Rolling, rolling, and no time there. Taken down at the 29-yard line. Second sack of the game for the Saints defense. 67 seconds to go. Great job by Mike Flacek. He's had a nice couple of series here as they go to the hurry-up offense. Up 28-0 right now. Crable throwing out route and has Dan Rixey up to the 40-yard line. Third down and 8 now for the Cougars. Gosh, they just seem dangerous when they're in the hurry up. Crable some time down the middle of the field and is incomplete. Looking for Colley again. But I believe it was Blake Evans who might have just got his hands up to obscure the vision of the wide receiver. Right there at the end. Blake Evans was there at the end of the play. It was Cody Randa, the linebacker, jumping up to perhaps throw the timing of that off. That brings up fourth down, and the Cougars are going to punt here with 36 and a half seconds to go. Justin Bruns, the return man at the 19-yard line. Punt is away, spirals to the right sideline. Bruns will catch it and just take a step out of bounds at the 22. 29 ticks remaining. Justin Bruns and Parade Barber in there with the high five before they take their spots. I would love to see more Parade Barber. And Parade's a great running back. He's a bowling ball out there. He just headhunts people. Unfortunately for him, Dwayne Milton and Mike Johnson are also on the team, two very talented running backs. St. Francis will be content here to take a knee and head into the locker room. Down 28-0. So far, a game and a half into the 2019 campaign against the number one and number three teams in the country. Unable to muster any points yet so far. And that will take us down to halftime. Still some things to figure out, but there's been a lot more bright spots this week than there was last week. Things improving. Let's see if Coach Curry, Matt McCarthy and company can come up with an answer offensively to try to put that ball in the end zone. We'll take a break. Come back. We'll go over some halftime numbers and get the second half underway. It's the home opener for the Saints football team. You're listening and watching Saints football on USF Sports TV Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2019 debut of your USF dance team.
Hey, Meander, she had a question for you about the
Come on, just let it sit there.
I'm going to be like, wow.
pleasure. I stay till
Yeah.
Welcome back to Joliet. Halftime score, 28-0. The St. Francis Indiana Cougars on top of the Fighting Saints over here for Joliet's home opener. My name's Nick Jacobs. Lee Turnbow typically with me here. Unfortunately, unable to make it in today. Feeling a bit under the weather. Lee, hope you feel better, buddy. We'll see you in about a month. That's the next home game. Take a look at the schedule at GoFightingSaints.com. Bright sunshine here at Memorial Stadium. A beautiful day, 78 degrees and sunshine at kickoff. And the conditions remain picture perfect here if you're not looking at the scoreboard. If you are, it's 28-0. Let's take a look at some of the numbers. St. Francis of Indiana, 200 yards through the air. Only just 19 on the ground, though. So not too bad defensively as far as the Saints are concerned, stopping the run. Unfortunately, the offense for the second game in a row kind of sputtering a bit, again, against one of the top five defenses in the country, however. St. Francis throwing 5 for 9 for just 70 yards, rushing it for just, looking at the wrong one there, 27 times for 76 yards. They are out-rushing the Cougars on the ground, but again, Matt Crable and that offense through the air for the Cougars look pretty unstoppable so far here today. Let's take a look individually. Major Dedmon, the leading rusher for the Saints, rushed it 14 times for 67 yards. Been sacked a few times. That affected the number, so a total of 31. Dwayne Milton carried it 7 times for 27 yards. Mike Johnson, 5 times for 20. Had a big, about 50-yard run called back because of a holding penalty, and that is something we'll get into in just a minute as well. Throwing the ball, Major Dedmon, like we mentioned, 5 for 9 for 70 yards. Been sacked 3 times so far today. Malik Roberts and Dwayne Milton both with 2 catches apiece. Roberts, 33 yards. Milton, 22. Brandon Ruffin, again, just 1 catch for 10 yards. For the Cougars, P.J. Dean leading the Cougars on the ground. 4 carries for 12 yards. Martell Williams, 3 carries for 6. Matt Crable has carried it 5 times for just a total of 4 yards, however, showing you how stout the run defense for the Saints has been. Unfortunately, Crable is 14 for 19 through the air for 200 yards and 4 touchdowns. The Saints defense has been able to get to him for 2 sacks, however. Dan Rixey has been the favorite target, 5 catches for 63. Rocky James, 4 catches for 64. Casey Cole has a couple of catches for 30 yards and a touchdown. Will Crispin has one 22-yard touchdown catch as well. Rocky James, by the way, 2 touchdowns to go along with it as well. Scoring plays for St. Francis, Indiana. It's been all through the air. Rocky James, a 26-yarder from Crable. Casey Cole, a 5-yarder from Crable. Will Crispin, that 22-yarder. Rocky James, a 13-yarder. In the second quarter there as well. Looks like we're about ready to get things underway as the Cougars finally making their way out of that locker room underneath the far side bleachers. Saints fans coming out today supporting their squad. Just enjoying the beautiful weather here we have today. So if you are looking at bright spots, the running defense, the rush defense has been outstanding for the Saints. And it's not like they've been getting beat too bad by the Cougars. They have shot themselves in the foot a few times. A couple penalties, like we mentioned. Michael Johnson's 50-plus yard run was called back. Brandon Ruffin had a drop that would have put the ball inside the 10-yard line, most likely. So a couple of drops, a couple of penalties, and who knows if that scores 1 or 2 touchdowns, could be a different complexion. But that's really all it takes. You get into the end zone one time, make a stop, that offense starts humming, start cutting down the lead, and you never know what can happen. But it all starts with slowing down Matt Crable and that high-flying offense that he has behind him. It'll be Saint football to start things off. Brandon Ruffin and Justin Bruns back to return. Gavin Gardner, the junior kicker for St. Francis, Indiana, out of Van Wert, Ohio. We'll start us off here in the second half. Defensively, by the way, Nick Lucas, 8 tackles, leads the Cougars. Jalen Cooper and John Pola, both with 4 for the Saints. It'll be Bruns from a yard deep in the end zone. If he lets that go, he gets to the 25, so that's pretty much the mark you better get to if you decide to run it out, and he does not do that. He takes it to the 21. Respectable return, and that is where Major Edmund and company will come out. I've seen enough Saints football to know that every now and again, they like to try and go for a home run ball here out of a timeout. So keep an eye on number 80 on the near side. Keep an eye on Malik Roberts, Dan Getch, RJ Williams. They'll be the three wide receivers left. Major Dedman, the true freshman, takes a snap. They're going to keep it safe here. First play to Dwayne Milton. He's pushed up. Nice break, but he drops the ball at the 35. The Cougars pick it up and start inside, deep inside Saint territory. Blake Schumacher, ball bounced right into his breadbasket. He takes it out of bounds. Oh, tough way to start it for the Saints. Dwayne Milton, not known for butterfingers, usually pretty secure with the football. It might have been popped out from behind. Taking a look at it again. Yep. Schumacher picked it up. First and 10 at the 35-yard line for Crable and the Cougar offense. Play action. They're going to look for the home run ball right down the middle. Wide open. They've run that play three or four times, and it's been there every single time. It's Duke Blackwell this time for the touchdown. Duke Blackwell, the junior out of New Palestine, Indiana, with his first touchdown in the last 2 years, and he's kind of a nice story. He tore his ACL back in the 2017 national title game, missed all of last year because of that injury. So he's getting his first start since that national title game 2 years ago. And he gets a 35-yard touchdown on the first play of the second half. Extra point is up and good. Well, let's try this again, shall we? Set it down 28-0. It's 35-0. Turnovers will do that. That was one of the keys to the game from Coach Curry in the beginning. Got to hold on to the football. And you can't really get on Dwayne Milton too much about it, as he does not do that often. Every once in a while, it'll happen. See if someone makes a big play here. Justin Bruns and Brandon Ruffin have switched sides here on the return. Let's see if Gardner and the special teams unit for the Cougars will recognize that and kick it away from Ruffin again. He's definitely the one who's got the big play ability. Not that that guy right there doesn't. Brandon Ruffin, number 80, leader in career yards and touchdowns as he starts his senior year. Just two catches so far this year, though. One last year and one in the first half. Or last week, I should say. Pardon me. They do kick to Bruns. Angle it left. And that one will go out of bounds. It'll be procedure penalty up to the 35. It'll go, I believe. Might be the 40 now that they take 14-22 just underway in the third quarter, 35-0. St. Francis does return four of their top seven tacklers from last year. Mason DeLong, Cody Randa, Hathon Hurdle, and Deshaun Dickinson, who unfortunately injured himself in the preseason, so unable to start the first couple of games. He was out there for the coin toss as a captain, though. They're missing him on the defensive line, no doubt. All right, here we go. Major Dedman in the pistol. Behind him is Milton. Ruffin is split out wide right, but the snap goes under his legs. Actually, it's the Wildcat formation. Was that Seth Williams, a freshman wide receiver back there? It still is Seth Williams, number two. Or unless that's a new jersey. Is that a new jersey for Major Dedmon, he did rip his jersey before. Yeah, that's number two, but it is Major Dedmon. I apologize. Ripped his jersey in the first half. Cornerback run. It's a draw play. He'll take it up to the 20-yard line. So we mentioned earlier how mistakes have shot St. Francis, Illinois in the foot in the first half, and already a fumble that's led to a touchdown, and then a botched snap that lost about 10 yards. So you see number two there, but it is number seven, Major Dedmon. He's going to throw this time. Finds Ruffin on the screen. If he's on tackle here, he does not. He would have been off to the races, but he was taken down at the 30-yard line. It's a pickup of 10. But it does bring up fourth down for the Saints to go for it here. They're going to have to punt it away. And to do the honors this time, Tyler Keene. There's been three punts in the first half. This will be the fourth opportunity. Tyler Keene's second punt of the game. Snap is good. Tyler with the left foot. Behind it from Tyler Keene. That was sky high. The best punt of the afternoon. The big news out of the NFL today, Antonio Brown and that continuing saga picked up by the Patriots. That's been the joke that's been made for the last couple of days ever since the word of Antonio Brown requesting him be released. Everyone jokes like, of course, he's probably going to be picked up by the Patriots, right? Well, it came to fruition. He is now a Patriot. And if you have Antonio Brown on your fantasy team, that's pretty good news. Here's Crable. If you have him on your NAIA fantasy team, you're going to do pretty good this year, although he throws incomplete, well defended by the Saints. 12:44 to go here in the third quarter. The defense has been improving from the opening kick. Chris Johnson there, the linebacker number 51, a sophomore from IC Catholic. Getting some time here, and one of the reserve linebackers, 31 tackles last season, had a sack as well. He's going to have an improved role here. Second down and 10, safeties drop back more. Linebacker drops back as well. I believe that's Evans. They're going to run it to Dean. He has a huge hole as he breaks it up to the 49 of the Saints for a first down, a pickup of 12 or 13 yards.
PJ Dean with the carry, tackled by number 51, Chris Johnson, number 13, Jonathan Boyd. Pick up 14 yards and a first down for the Cougars.
That's the longest run of the game for the Cougars. They're going to give it to Dean again. Hops in the backfield. Nope, it's a quarterback keeper by Crable out to the outside. First time they've shown that look. Well, Crable with his athleticism out to the 25-yard line and another first down for the boys in blue. By Crable doing it on the ground, something they haven't done in the first half. Draw play to Dean, and he's got some blockers ahead of him. He'll take it up for a first down. Leaps before he's smashed to the ground at the 15-yard line. That one goes for 19 yards. So just as we were talking about the strength of the Saint defense being on stopping the run game, three straight 15-yard-plus rushes by the Cougars. Now, about 59 total yards on the ground for the Cougars here. First and 10 inside the red zone again. Wing back motions behind the tackle. Snap to Crable. Looking into the end zone. On the post route, it is caught. Kolmankiewicz, touchdown. Crable right on the money. 11-10 to go. That pushes the score up to 41-0.
16-yard touchdown
play. See it again here. Right over the head of the linebacker in coverage. And there wasn't much that Cody Randa was going to do with that one as the extra point. Is up and good. 42-0, 11-10 to go. Third quarter. Again, another top three team in the nation flexing some muscle here against the Saints. Unable to slow down the passing attack of the Cougars. That drive, five plays, 63 yards. Took just 101 seconds. There are definitely some gifts given by the Saints to the Cougars today in terms of turnovers. That isn't to say that offense isn't something to be reckoned with, as this is just the first. Typically see a lot of improvement from the Cougars side is going to be. They look pretty good here today. Passing the ball, you know, a lot of timing is something that you typically need to work on at the beginning of the season, but the timing looks pretty spot on for Crable and his wide receivers. Low kick. This will be a return opportunity for Bruns from the 9-yard line. Looking for some blocking help. Runs into a wall of Saints before he's stopped at the 27-yard line. Crable now 16 for 22 with six touchdowns through the air. All the touchdowns so far for the Cougars have been through the passing game. On the ground, 66 yards total as a team. 44 from Dean, 19 from Crable, both with six carries apiece. First down and 10. Handoff. It is Parade Barberin, but a flag will take that 8-yard run back, I would believe, in a position of holding.
Carried by number 3, Pierre Barberin. But there is a penalty marker on the field.
Usually, if you want to find out who committed the penalty, look for the guy with his palms to the sky. That'd be Derek Wentworth on this particular occasion, the sophomore from Minooka. A nice offensive line talent, signed on at Bemidji State after high school, transferred to USF before that season started last year. Multiple D1 offers. So the penalty was at about the line of scrimmage. Back to the 19-yard line. Sweep goes to Johnson. Cuts it back inside up the numbers. We'll take it back to the original line of scrimmage with a 9-yard pickup. Mike Johnson has been fun to watch today. He had a nice big run taken back because of penalty earlier in the first half. his senior year. You know he's going to want to go out playing the best football he possibly can. Same thing with Dwayne Milton. Second down and 10 now for the Saints. 10-17 to go in the third. Johnson in motion again. They hand it to him on the sweep. It's some blocking outside. Can't quite find the edge, though, as he takes it to the 34-yard line. Make it the 33. 5-yard pickup. Third down and 5 for the Saints. There's Dwayne Milton and Mike Johnson. Mike's going to come out. So the running back will come out for a wide receiver here on third and 5. That's R.J. Williams, who will line up slot. Dan Getch wide left. Brandon Ruffin near right. Another quarterback draw for Denman, looking for the 35, and he'll get there, but that's only a 1-yard pickup on the quarterback keeper. Fourth down, and the punt unit comes on. Tyler Keene, again, the punter. 9:35 and counting here in Joliet, third quarter. Deadman 6 for 10 through the air for 79 yards. On the ground, he's run it 15 times, make it 16 times for 37 yards. Dwayne Milton has been the most effective. Milton averaging about 5 yards per carry. Exactly 5 yards per carry. Eight rushes, 40 yards for Dwayne. Sun peeking back through the clouds here. Off to the west, there appear to be some darker rain clouds threatening. And that one takes a nice bounce. That'll be inside the 10-yard line. We're talking about a 65-yard net punt there by Tyler. Nice bounce. .850 to go here in the ball game, or in the third quarter, pardon me. Head coach Kevin Donnelly and all that he's done in his 41 years in coaching, 22 years at St. Francis, Indiana. He just signed a contract extension in the offseason that keeps him in Fort Wayne through the 2023 season. You see some of the dark clouds appearing over Joliet. Right now, some sunshine, but they are creeping in. Crable has it. Worst starting position of the game for the Cougars. The inside run only goes backward. Looks like maybe lost a yard if he got back to the line of scrimmage at all. Brings up second down.
Carry by number 24, Martell Williams. Tackle by number 36, Cody Randa. No gain in the play. Second and 10 to the Cougars.
Second down and 10 at the 8-yard line. See if St. Francis dials something up. Three down linemen. See how many they rush. They're going to run it. Williams, again, bottled up at the line of scrimmage. No gain. The run defense for the Saints has been strong. But after a pickup of 1, it's 3rd and 9. You always get nervous when Matt Crable is in a passing situation here. He has been on the money all day long, as you see the three defensive linemen for St. Francis. Conrad Ochitorina, Chris Peters, Jake Pott. Crable snap. The blitz is on by the Saints. Can't get there in time. Chrisman, the crossing round, picks up the first down. He needed 9. He got 11 out to the 20. Big 6'6" wide receiver right across the middle. See it again. Great blocking up front by that offensive line. And Chrisman finds the soft spot between the linebackers and the secondary, and he picks up the first down. I believe we have a new quarterback into the game for the Cougars. That would be Heath Simmons, the freshman out of Hartford, Kentucky. Getting their backup a little bit of playing time here, up 42-0. About 6:45 left to go here in the third quarter. Now, typically you would see that here on your screen, but they've updated their equipment here at Memorial Stadium and failed to notify all the necessary parties. Simmons throws across the middle and finds his man again. Schmeling up near the 50-yard line, and Simmons look impressive. Did you see him just go through his progressions on the play? Looking left, looking right. Finds his man up the middle for the big gainer up to the 49. Impressive play by the freshman quarterback.
First down, St. Francis, Indiana.
Nothing there, nothing there. There's my guy, fires. Right on the money. Schmeling picks up the first down. First down and 10 at the Cougar 49. Screens it out left side, but it throws that one into the ground. It was a forward pass, not a fumble. Brings up second down.
Simmons
And we welcome in all the Saints fans and Cougar fans. If you're listening out in Indiana, if you're family for either team, we appreciate you tuning in and watching. Two wide receivers left, one to the right here for quarterback. Again, play action, post route, and picks up another big first down, about 19 yards out to Dylan Hundley and Heath Simmons. Just a freshman. Are you telling me they have another all-world quarterback just waiting in the wings? Unfortunately, he might have gotten popped here. Let's see who's on the ground. Nope, it's not their quarterback. Who got hurt? Look at that. Perfect, perfect throw. We do have an injured Cougar on the ground, though. I didn't see a number, but I think it's Chrisman, just judging by how tall that man is. As it sits right now, on top of the Midwest League in the MSFA, Trinity International, the number one team. They're 1-0. Meeting Presentation South Dakota last week. It is Chrisman, number 11. Looks to be a left ankle there, or knee. I wish him all the best. He is a weapon for the Cougar passing game, especially in the red zone with that big 6'6" frame. So hopefully that's not gonna prohibit him from missing too much action here as the season goes forward. All the best for Will Chrisman there. Down and 10 for the Cougars. They're at the Saint 31. 5:40 to go. Clock will start rolling after the referee whistle. Not off the field yet, however, slowly making his way to the Cougar sideline. Here we go. Williams, the tailback, behind Simmons, the freshman quarterback. Play action. He'll roll right. Fires across his body and nearly intercepted by the Saints. It was knocked away defensively. Let's see who knocked that one. Again, he's having a nice game, is John Pullen. That one, a pass breakup for the freshman out of Joliet West, right down the road from where we're sitting here. Second down and 10 for Simmons and company. Counterplay. Williams right, cuts it up the numbers. It'll be 9, maybe 10 yards. Yep, that's going to be 10 yards on the carry for another Cougar first down. Faked it left, countered over to the right side for the run. Picked up the first down. Martell Williams, the sophomore out of Indianapolis. Not sure we'll see PJ again. He's on the bench with 6 carries for 44 yards. Hathon Hurdle on the stop on that last play. Play action again. Simmons looking left, looking into the end zone and caught at the 2 and a touchdown. Somebody forgot about Matt Komankiewicz, a junior wide receiver. He picks up his second touchdown of the game. Matt Komankiewicz, 2 catches, 2 touchdowns. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight total Cougars receivers have caught passes so far today. Extra point on the way and good. 4:45 to go in the third quarter. 48-0 right now, and that aerial attack by the Cougars cannot be stopped. That was their best drive of the game. Starting back at their own 7-yard line, they go 10 plays, 93 yards in 4 minutes and 5 seconds. Newly added to the football season this year, the NAIA Football Classic. Inviting years from around the NAIA to come down and play in an exhibition football game down in Georgia. It'll be the week before the championship game. And there have been 4 invited to come down. Cody Randa, Zach Bikema, Dwayne Milton, and Brandon Ruffin. With the most invites is Marion University, of course, an MSFA school. They have 11 players. And I perused the roster. I did not see one St. Francis, Indiana player in the NAIA Classic. Not exactly sure why. They have plenty of seniors that you would think would qualify. Like their two top receivers, Rocky James and Dan Riske. Or their all-conference safety, Blake Schumacher. But a lot, no. No Cougars on that NAIA Classic roster. A penalty on the kickoff there. The Saints will have it at the 35 as it went out of bounds. 4:45 to go in the third. Saints still trying to find their first points of the season. Milton on the sweep. It'll be Deadman on the keeper. Up to the 35, the original line of scrimmage. Linebackers and defensive linemen for the Cougars doing well to stay home on any motion type play. Deadman probably is about 50-50 on keeping it and handing it off. Really haven't gone to Ruffin. He's not on the field right now. That snap is on the ground, but picked up and before he's taken down by his ankle after only a gain of 2 there on the stop for St. Francis of Indiana. It was 35. I'm looking at my roster, and I don't have a number 35. That's what happened to get to this point. See that rough snap again. Malcolm Britton getting his first start at center in his career. Throwing and incomplete, looking for Malik Roberts across the middle past midfield, but that's going to bring up fourth down now for the Saints. Offense will have to come off the field again, send out the punt unit. Tyler Keene out to punt it for the fifth punt, I believe, for the Saints. Keene puts his left boot into it, skies it backward. Fair catch called for, made at the 27-yard line by Dylan Hundley. And on comes the backup quarterback again, Heath Simmons in St. Francis, Indiana. The Saints are 0-4 against the Cougars of St. Francis, Indiana. This is their fifth meeting. Other games in the schedule in the MSFA today. St. Xavier out at Lawrence Tech earlier today. Olivet Nazarene was at Siena Heights. That would be a great game. Trinity International up in Minnesota take on St. Thomas. St. Ambrose is down at Missouri Baptist. See the run on the inside up past the 30-yard line. Taylor at Robert Morris, Illinois, up in Chicago at 2. And this is the final game of the MSFA schedule. Last week was only just a handful of games. Trinity Bible was at St. Ambrose, but that game got canceled. Lion beat Missouri Baptist, Lion Alabama, I believe, or Arkansas. And then Trinity International won at Presentation 28-26. This the full the first week of a full slate of games in the MSFA. All in the Mideast. And give to Eli Wallace the tailback. 5'10", 211-pound junior out of LaGrance, Indiana. Did play in four games last year. Carried it 25 times, 143 yards, and two touchdowns. So you see Oshikahi Ebikumi, the 6'4", 210-pound freshman out of Hinsdale South on the defensive line for St. Francis. Third down and 8 to go. I should say 7. Blitz being shown. Here come the linebackers. Gets rid of it out to the outside. Is it going to be enough for the first down, though? They need to get to the 37. Looks like they got the 36, about a yard shy to the 5'11 receiver, Jordan Schmeling. Clock will continue to run here on fourth down and 1. Under 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Schmeling and Hathan Hurdle. Starter cornerback coming back again for his junior year. And St. Francis, Indiana will punt it away. Taking all the time they can off the clock before they got a big punt away. Bruns retreats to make the catch inside the 20-yard line. 1:19 to go in the third quarter. 48-0 is the score. It's going to be all Major Deadman here. You're not going to see Jamal Salam unless there's an injury to Major. The reason for that is, well, the true freshman just needs all the reps he can possibly get. Whether it's a close competitive game or you're down 49-0, everything is valuable for a true freshman, especially at quarterback. They give to Johnson. He's got a little room. He'll twist his way past the 30-yard line for an 11 or 12-yard carry and a first down for the Saints. Just the 9th first down of the game for the Fighting Saints. That's to 23 for the Cougars. The Saints are out-rushing the Cougars, 94-86 on the ground. But the Cougars have 333 yards through the air compared to just 79 for St. Francis, Illinois. 419 total yards for the Cougars, 173 for the Saints here. Johnson in motion. Play action here from Deadman. He'll fire across the middle. What a beautiful pass to Dwayne Milton. Right over the shoulder grab near the 42-yard line. Oh, my goodness. Oh, they say he dropped it. Okay, I thought they were going to call a penalty. Thought he caught that ball. Take a look at it again. Oh, yeah, that did come out. That's some pretty good officiating. I did not see that in live action, but they're absolutely right. Incomplete pass. Milton goes in motion. He'll take it on the sweep. He's got a blocker in front of him, and Johnson, he breaks through past, or at least near the 50-yard line. They're going to mark him at the 49. It's going to go for a 15-yard carry and a first down and an injured Cougar back near the St. 30-yard line. That's Kevion Evans, the defensive lineman, the freshman from Toledo, on the ground. Getting the freshmen some playing time on both sides of the ball here with 32 seconds to go in the third quarter. Big Derek Wentworth right there. He's got a personality, too. Had a chance to talk with him last year on the season opener when we flew out to Sacramento against Sacramento State. He's a character, man. He's a funny guy. Nice to have around. Good locker room dude. He's just his second year wearing a Saints jersey, but already a team captain. First down for the Saints at their own 49. We got 15 seconds, clock ticking down. If they're going to run a play, it'll be the last one of the quarter. Dedmon's going to hand off to Milton and try the same play, and it picks up about five that time. He's pushed out of bounds with 6 seconds left to go in the quarter.
Dwayne Milton with the carry, pushed out of bounds by number 37, Mike Adams. Pick up a three on the play, second and seven for the Saints.
They gave him three, and the clock will tick down here. That'll be the end of quarter number three. 49-0 Cougars of St. Francis. The Saints of St. Francis just looking to improve here as we go into the fourth quarter, looking for some positive things to happen as we go into the fourth against the top three team in the country. Back right after this, you're watching Saints football on the SFTV network.
Our conference meet, so it's kind of our biggest meet of the year. Sharon was a Lindsey Wilson runner. We'd known each other for a long time, and she is a sweetheart. She's absolutely adorable. You would never want anything bad to happen to her in a race, ever.
And we were 2.5 miles into it, and Darcy and I were in second and third, and Sharon was in first. We knew that she had gone the wrong way because we could barely still see her. She was still pretty far in front of us.
She still came in third place at the finish, but I came in first and Danielle came in second. Immediately, we just go, no! We like both literally did this motion with our arms.
We didn't want the credit for first and second because we knew that's not what it really was.
Well, I'm very proud of our girls. You know, you can't help but be proud. Anytime someone does the right thing, no matter what.
We interrupt this very important PSA to bring you more football. Welcome back to Joliet. Fourth quarter about to get underway as they Dedmon is sacked in the backfield, making the play behind the line of scrimmage. Number 44, Jackson Long, the freshman linebacker from St. John, Indiana. His first sack of his college career, I would imagine. Dedmon undecided what to do with the football there. Makes it third down and 12. Third quarter numbers. 51 plays, 419 yards for the Cougars. 50 plays, 206 for the Saints. Pass heavy have been the Cougars today. Here's Dedmon dropping back to throw. Down the middle and incomplete. A heck of a play in the middle by River Walsh, the freshman linebacker. That brings up fourth down. Tyler Keene's got to come back out and punt it away. Most points in a St. Francis, Indiana win in this particular rivalry was back in 2017, the year they won the national championship. They beat the Saints 68-23. As the Keen punt is angled left, the return will start from the 28-yard line. Right up the near sideline goes Komunkevich. And he's knocked out of bounds at the 44.
Returned by number one, Matt Kanikowicz. Pushed out of bounds by number 33, Noah Fritz. And number four, Horizon Williams.
The largest margin of victory was 45 points, that being that same game back in 2017, 68-23. As it sits right now, this would be the largest victory for the Cougars over the Saints in this series. It's the fifth game all time between these two teams. Going to run it right side and a nice form tackle. Blake Evans. He's going to be a stud on that defense.
Carry by number 22, Tony Johnson.
Just a junior, a transfer out of, again, Concordia St. Paul, and that carry made by Tony Johnson, the sophomore running back out of Indianapolis. Schedule for St. Francis, Indiana. After today, they have another road game up at Robert Morris before their home opener is on September 28th, taking on St. Ambrose. takes it for a first down. Taking the long ways, they sweep it over to the left side, but he picks up the first down out of bounds at the 44-yard line. So home opener for the Cougars will be September 28th against St. Ambrose, then on the road at Marion. That will be a great game, a battle of some top 10 teams. And then they have another top 10 team October 12th at home against Concordia, Michigan. Then out to Indiana Wesleyan, another tough matchup at a beautiful brand new stadium out there at Wesleyan. And they take on two games on the road. Lawrence Taylor, Indiana. Throwing on the run, the one-handed grab in the flat is made. Turning upfield to the 33. A flag comes in late. But a heck of a catch. Made by Nick Brickens, the wing back. He just had three catches last year, but flash of brilliance there by Nick. And you got to give the Cougars some credit because they gathered as a team, as we get the call here. It's going to be a penalty on the Cougars as they march it backward 10 yards, so you can pretty much erase that catch and run. Block in the back, I believe, the call. But the Cougars gathered as a team to watch the Saints last week. They watched that 80-0 shellacking they took from the defending national champions Morningside. But when they were asked by the media about it, they said the right things. The quarterback, Crable, said that they, the Saints, are not a team that gets beat 80-0 and then just comes out the next week and lays down. They're going to give us their best shot, and we're going to be ready for it. And that appears that they were. There's a blitz coming in for the Saints. Throwing left, looking long, incomplete, just a bit too much underneath it. Intended for number 85, Jay Siegel, the sophomore wide receiver from Lafayette, Indiana. Coach Kevin Donnelly pretty much echoing what Crable said. He said, it's been my experience that if someone goes through that humiliation, they're going to come out the next week like their hair's on fire. That's what Coach Donnelly said of the Cougars. And I think the Saints did that. I think they came out. They had a great week of practice per Coach Curry. Well, there's just no accounting for the talent that the Cougars have, especially offensively. And we're going to have a false start. A pile of laundry on the field across the line of scrimmage there. 12:19 to go here in the game as the cloud cover continues to roll in here at Memorial Stadium. It's Coach Curry in his eighth year, 39-38 as a head coach in his 19th year with the St. Francis football program. Started off as a player. Went to defensive coordinator and head coach. Actually won the Midwest Conference Coach of the Year back in 2015 when the Saints won the conference championship. Trying to find the footing ever since. Second down and 20 here for the Cougars. Inside screen pass is incomplete. Intended receiver was Wallace, and he took a bit of a pop there at the end of the play. It's Chris Johnson, the linebacker, putting on the hurt. Don't forget, for all the St. Francis Athletics news that you need, all the schedules, the results, statistics, stories, you can check out GoFightingSaints.com. Here comes some pressure. Screen pass incomplete again. Again, it was looking for Wallace, just a bit too far out in front of him from the freshman quarterback, Heath Simmons. 12:10 to go. Fourth down, punt unit coming out for the Cougars. St. Francis with five penalties for 52 yards today. Reversed a couple of big plays. They also have two turnovers, both fumbles. The punt. It'll be Bruns. Runs up to make the catch. Cuts it back toward the middle of the field. Runs into his own at about the 29-yard line. Scott Walsh. Long snapper, I believe.
and number 37, Mike Adams.
Could have been Dominic Cooper as well, one of the up backs who we ran in. It was Cooper that Bruns ran into. There's Justin Bruns, the sophomore wide receiver on a Bellwood Proviso West. Denman in the pistol again. He's going to run it behind Mike Johnson. To the left of the numbers, and he's pushed out of bounds at about the 40. That should be a first down run there for Major Denman. You can see his toughness, can't you? You can see why he was a state championship wrestler last year in high school. I believe it was 170 pounds. Not afraid to take a hit. Reminds me a lot of Trace Wadless in that way. And that was kind of the downfall for Trace. He was an amazing athlete. Preferred to run over throw. Preferred contact, but he was often injured because of it. Hopefully that doesn't happen to Major. Looking to throw, but his arm was knocked away. Are they going to say fumble or, it should have been an incomplete pass, I think. A big hit there and a flag coming in. Several flags coming in. I believe it was going to, hard to tell, but I think it was a face mask. There's a lot of extracurricular activity, though, on the far side of the field. Still kind of sorting things out. I think we're going to have a unsportsmanlike penalty on the Cougars here, but we'll see. Still having a meeting of the minds here. Let's see what happened at the end of this. A stiff arm there from Johnson. A big hit. Nothing really happened there. Oh, somebody was pushing there from the Cougars. Wait, what? I think they called it on St. Francis on number 66, Lupe Aravalos. Looked like he was the one who was pushed from behind at the end of that play. I'm not sure if we can get another look at it before we get the snap off, but see if we can take a look what happened at the end of the play here after that was knocked out of his hands. They said that was a live ball. Mike Johnson picked it up. Let's keep an eye on 66, which is Lupe Oliveros. He's off the left side of your screen. Oh, okay. Yep, there it is. I definitely didn't see that first. He was pushed in retaliation. Okay, so you can see why the play happened. There we go. That's why we have the replay. Good officiating on the play. That was definitely a penalty. Frustration penalty, you would think, for Lupe there. Zip 11:20 to go in the ball game. St. Francis is on the road the next 3 weeks up in Deerfield to take on Trinity International next week. A traditional 1 o'clock start. And they travel up to Michigan in Ann Arbor, Michigan. Nope, not the big house though. They're going to take on Concordia, Michigan. Number 16, six team. They're rated number six in the NAIA. And then it's back to Michigan next week in the suburbs of Detroit to take on Lawrence Tech before they come home for two in a row against Robert Morris and Olivet Nazarene. They have a timeout of the field, by the way. Four of their last six games are home games. Robert Morris, Olivet, then they go up to Chicago to take on St. Xavier. Missouri Baptist at home to start off the month of November. The final road trip will be out to Davenport November 9th to take on the Fighting Bees of St. Ambrose. And then it is the second game of the year with St. Xavier. That'll be the conference game at home here at Memorial Stadium to finish up the season. Second down and 30 after the penalty. And a snap goes over Deadman's head. It goes from bad to worse as the Cougars jump on it inside the 10.
Fumble recovered by number
St. Francis, Indiana will have it first and goal at the Saints 9-yard line.
You know, tough schedules are great in theory. You want to play some of the best in the country, but when you play the number one team in the country, the defending national champs, and then the number three team in the country, the team that won the national championship the previous 2 years, especially with a freshman quarterback, a new center, a lot of new faces offensively and defensively, you're going to get, we'll call these preparing the young men for the future. He takes the snap and hands off to Wallace, inside run up to the 5. 11-10 to go in the game.
Carry by number 15, Eli Wallace. Nick Murray, Jonathan Pullen on the stop.
Nick Murray, and you hear again Jonathan Pullen's name today. He's had a nice game defensively. Top 3 in tackles. Congratulations to the St. Francis volleyball team beating Indiana University South Bend to open up the CCAC conference schedule for them. Winning in straight sets. Our inside run here for the Cougars takes it inside the 5-yard line. It'll be third down and goal. Mentioned before, the St. Francis soccer team played right here at Memorial Stadium before the football team took the field. They won 1-0 as we hit the 10-minute mark here in quarter number 4. Give to Wallace. Nope, Simmons going to keep it, but he's met at the line and denied the end zone. It'll be a loss of a few. The stop made by Mason DeLong.
Quarterback keeper by Simmons. Stopped on the play by number 47, Mason DeLong. Pick up the play. Fourth and goal for the Cougars.
Fourth down and goal, they're going to go for it. Getting their young players some red zone reps here. And I don't fault them for it. I know it's 49-0, but it's their first game of the season as Eli Wallace punches it in for a touchdown. This is the first game of the season for St. Francis, Indiana. So they're, you know, trying to get as many reps as they can too. And you see Eli Wallace do the Khalil Mack post sack dance after his touchdown. Not one single player on the Cougars roster from Illinois. Majority from Indiana or Ohio. No one, surprisingly, from Illinois. A couple from Kentucky. Their freshman quarterback that we've been seeing the last quarter and a half. He's from Hartford, Kentucky. But they know how to recruit in their circle. That's for sure. See some dark clouds overhead here at Memorial Stadium with 9:01 to go. Fifty-six to nothing. So far, the Saints to the number one team and number three team are 136-0 in the first two games. I know people are going to look at the schedule, look at the results in those scores, and, you know, they're going to have opinions about the Saints team, but my gosh, Morningside and St. Francis, Indiana are going to do this to a lot of teams. They're going to do this to a lot of teams. It just so happens that St. Francis wasn't afraid to schedule both of them in the first 2 weeks of the season. A dark cloud over this game for sure. Kickoff again going out of bounds. They'll take it up to the 35-yard line with 9:01 to go. See if the Saints offense can get their first points of the season on the board here. Major Denman, the freshman quarterback out of Freeport. We do our trivia question. Now seems like an appropriate time. So obviously the home opener for the Saints today against St. Francis, Indiana. When was the last time they won their home opener is our trivia question. We're going to look at that as they go long to Ruffin. It is incomplete. When was the last time the Saints won their home opener here at Memorial Stadium? It's their 33rd year in existence. The answer, you have to go back all the way to 2014. It was a 41-10 victory over Olivet Nazarene. But they, like they did this year, they schedule some very tough teams earlier in the year before they get down to the conference schedule, which this is a conference game today. No, I take that back. This is a cross-conference game. I correct myself. Thankfully. So who are the conference foes for St. Francis of Illinois? Trinity International next week. Robert Morris, Olivet Nazarene, Missouri Baptist, St. Ambrose, St. Xavier. So that's probably the way you have to look at it. And these first two games, you're playing some pretty tough competition. 80-0. It's 56-0 right now. But you haven't even started your conference schedule yet. Here's Dedman. Oh. Had to evade the pressure here. He does. Looking for a little help. Barberin, the block, up past the 50. There goes Major. Just don't hurt yourself. Which he did.
Major Denton with a carry, by number 51, Emmanuel Davis.
So like we mentioned, first two games of the season here, non-conference games, so you just have to focus on your conference. Winnable games with Trinity International, with Robert Morris, with Olivet Nazarene, with Missouri Baptist. The toughest conference games are going to be St. Ambrose, Olivet, and St. Xavier. As Major Denman, the true freshman quarterback, will be on the ground. And there in the foreground, number five, Jamal Salam, the transfer quarterback. He's a junior, and we're going to see him for the first time this season. On the very next play, we'll see what happened here to Major. He ducks out of the way from the pressure there, looking for a little help. Got a block from Pere Barberin. He's kind of landed on that wrist, or maybe he took the knee to the back of the head, too. That was a possibility there. An inadvertent knee. No, I don't think so. I'm not exactly sure. That's a tough one. It looks like they're holding his left knee down. If you take a little live shot here, they're focusing on that left leg. Either way, they stopped play for his injury, so he's going to have to come out for at least a play. I imagine there's really no reason to put him back in, even if he's a little bit injured. Go ahead and just have him take a seat and let's see what the junior transfer from California, Jamal Salam, can do. More of a passing quarterback. Not much of a runner, but we'll see. A junior as opposed to the freshman. If I'm Brandon Ruffin, now's my time to go for the end zone, I think. He's stacked up down at the left of the line, bottom of your screen. Here's Jamal. He's firing right side. Beautiful ball. Overshot Bruns just a little bit, but you see how quick of a release he had on that, too. He knew exactly where he was. And you can see the difference in style between Dedman and Salam immediately.
Ball's incomplete. Second and 10 for the Saints.
It's a bit overthrown that time by Jamal. 7:50 to go. His brother Jameel Salam has followed him to Joliet from California. He's a wide receiver. Jamal checks it down to Roberts up to the 38-yard line before he's tackled by three Cougars. I don't know if I'd be celebrating too much there, Malik.
So long as pass complete to number 89, Malik Roberts.
It's a nice catch, though. No doubt about it. Third down and one.
Pick up a nine on the play. Third and one for the Saints.
High snap, turn and give to Pere Barberin for the first down to the 30-yard line. 7:19 to go. Is it just me or is there a little more pep, a little more energy? That St. Francis, Illinois offense. There's Pere, the golden shoes to match the golden mouth protector. There's Jamal Salam. There's those cleats. Snap to Jamal, steps up in the pocket, fires right side, and Justin Bruns was running the fly route when I think Jamal Salam thought he was going to stop. Brings up second down to 10, 31-yard line of the Cougars, 6:48 to go. Every single home game you can watch right here on the USF YouTube channel. Just go to GoFightingSaints.com for the link, or just follow them on YouTube right now. Second down to 10. They hand off to Pere. He ran into a wall of Cougars there and only picked up one or two up to the 30-yard line. Third down and we'll say eight to go. Pere Barberin, a junior out of New Orleans, Louisiana, St. Augustine High School. He is a fun, fun running back to watch when he gets the football. If he gets some space, Jamal takes the snap. Here comes the blitz. Picked up, thrown long, right side, into the end zone, incomplete. Again, looking for Justin Bruns on the play. That was a catchable ball, but with the cornerback, it slowed him down just a little bit. But and while I appreciate Justin Bruns' speed, take a look who you got on the left side. Double teamed, I wasn't watching, but I'm lofting one up to Brandon Ruffin here on fourth down and eight. Single wide left. There he is, number 80 with the arm sleeve. Here comes pressure. And open inside the 10-yard line and a first down and goal by R.J. And a little life here in the stadium as they approach the end zone. They've been in the red zone once already this game. Turned it over, though, in the end zone. Or in the red zone, I should say.
22-yard pickup on the pass play. First and goal for the Saints.
Barberin in the backfield. They fake it to Milton. It'll be Jamal Salam on the carry inside the five, up to the three. 5:20 remaining in the ball game.
Pick up a four on the play. Second and goal, goal to three.
And a timeout's going to be called here by the Cougars. I think they're trying to pitch the shutout here, but Jamal Salam comes in for the injured Major Deadman and leading them down to a first and goal situation. Take a look at the skies here over Memorial Stadium. Cooling things down just a little bit. Salam 2 for 5 since taking over for 31 yards. Deadman was 6 for 14 for 79 yards. As Coach Curry's going to have something to think about now, isn't he? I know you want to get your starter comfortable in the offense. Pretty good. There's Brandon Ruff, and you can see a little bit of frustration in his body language here, can't you? An NAIA honorable mention player, only able to get two catches. He's going to sit this play out, which is surprising, too. And try to punch the ball in with Michael Johnson, the tailback, and try to run it. We'll see. Going to line up with a couple tight ends. Don't discount a trick play either. Got Trips near side on the right. Those are three big wide receivers. Milton in motion. They're going to give it to Dwayne, looking for some help. Cuts it up, and he is in for the touchdown. A huge sigh of relief here at Memorial Stadium. Dwayne Milton gets the first points of the season for the Saints. And the one celebrating the most, Jamil Salam. It's Jamal Salam's brother. You'll see it once again here. Some big blockers out front for Dwayne. Cuts it, makes one cut, plants that foot, dives for the end zone, and gets half the football over the goal line for the touchdown. Extra points good. 56-7. Dwayne Milton. Sixth touchdown of his career here with the Saints after transferring from Northern Illinois. Over 1,000 yards last year. Not a lot of touchdowns because, well, Brandon Ruffin had a bunch. He had 14. The kids who stand on the track behind the field goal post like the shag balls when the kickers are warming up. Good place to watch a game. A beautiful evening here in Joliet. Best drive of the season so far, 12 plays, 65 yards, just over 4 minutes. Major did it, had a leg injury, went out. Jamal Salam came in and looked pretty good. And he's getting a discussion right now with his coaching staff up in the booth here. And the kick, as we're back underway. End over end kick, return will be from the 10. Up the sideline, back toward the numbers where he's wrapped up around the 40-yard line. Return man was Mike Adams, the freshman out of Indy. Looking down there for Major Dedman. I'm not sure if they just packed him up and had him take off his pads and send him to the locker room or if he's on the field somewhere watching. I couldn't pick him out of the bench here yet. First and 10, blitz being shown right of the quarterback. Saints will bring a few extra. They run to the opposite side and no gain on that play. Williams, I believe that was wrapped up. There he is, Major Dedman. Doesn't have his helmet though, I don't think. I don't suspect he'll be going back in the game. No reason for him to risk any further injury. Yep, not carrying his helmet, but he does have his right leg wrapped up. But that wasn't, I think that's been wrapped up the entire time. There's Major, true freshman out of Freeport. Here's another trivia question for you. Can you tell me the mascot of Freeport High School? It's one of my favorites. The Pretzels. True, look it up, Google it. I think there's two teams in Illinois that are named the Pretzels, actually. I may be wrong on that, but I definitely knew Freeport is one. Conrad Ochitarina, the junior defensive lineman out of California. Getting some reps there on the defensive line. Sean Dickinson would be a mainstay there, but he's injured since the preseason. throwing to the outside. It's caught upfield near midfield for the first down, it appears, at the moment. Jordan Schmeling, another catch. He will pick up the first down. Schmeling has four catches now for approaching 50 yards receiving. The Cougars over 300 yards through the air today, 343. 442 total yards, 109 on the ground. First and 10 at midfield. We're under 3 minutes to play here in the ball game. They give again inside. Again, nothing much there. The defensive line, linebackers have played well against the run. The Saints have. Among the tacklers, Mason DeLong. Michael Johnson, not the running back, but the defensive lineman, freshman from Immaculate Conception in Hillside. Number 20, Jalen Cooper. He was a nice get. He's a true freshman out of Edwardsville High School. Offers from Milliken and offers from St. Ambrose. He said of Coach Bonds and Curry, they're like my grandpa and my mom. Just a home feeling, which is why he chose to come to St. Francis. Ooh, look out there on the sidelines there. Dangerous play as 22 Tony Johnson went out of bounds and hit the field goal kicking net. First down for the Cougars, under 2 minutes to go here in the game. Dwayne Milton, 11 carries, 62 yards, a score. Mike Johnson, 9 carries, 51 yards, no score. There, we'll see this end of the run again here by Torrey, who's out of bounds. It could have been a late hit call there by Johnson. Actually, hit him a bit out of bounds, but no penalty flag. First down and 10 after the carry. Johnson, the tailback. Simmons, the freshman quarterback. I'm going to run it the rest of the way here, I'd imagine. I'd pick up one. The clock starts to wind again. 1:44 and rolling.
Johnson with the carry for St. Francis, Indiana. 1 yard pickup, second and 9.
Another inside run just to keep the clock ticking down. It's just a gain of 1 third down and 8.
Johnson again, the carry. Stopped by Jacob Moore, Michael Johnson.
Thank everyone joining us on the YouTube stream. You can see quite the lively chat going on there of both Saint and Cougars fans. Appreciate that. Third down, Heath Simmons, the freshman quarterback, into the game. Looks like they sat their starter, Matt Crable, about halfway through the third quarter. The run goes to Johnson up to the 30-yard line. It's going to bring you up fourth down and 4, but that's also going to bring us to the end of the game here with 13 seconds left to go. Final's going to be 56-6. First touchdown of the season scored by Dwayne Milton late here in the fourth quarter. They will shake hands at midfield, and we'll take a look at some of the final numbers here very quickly. For St. Francis, Major Denman, 6 for 14 for 79 yards, had a long of 30. Jamal Salam came in, threw five passes, looked pretty sharp for 31 yards, ran the ball a few times as well, or one time, I should say, for 4 yards. Dwayne Milton, 11 carries, 62 yards and a score. Mike Johnson, 9 for 51. Major Denman ran it 23 times for 46 yards, a long of 29. Paray Barber in a couple runs for 8 yards. Jamal Salam, that one carry for 4. Malik Roberts, the favorite target. He had 3 catches for 42. Dwayne Milton, 2 catches for 27 yards. Brandon Ruffin, 2 catches just for 19 yards. The All-American honorable mention. R.J. Williams caught a ball for 22 as well. For St. Francis of Indiana, Crable goes 16 for 22, 251 yards and 6 touchdowns. The freshman Heath Simmons came in, threw it 11 times, completed 6 passes for 89 yards and a touchdown as well. On the ground, it was P.J. Dean, 6 carries for 44 yards. Tony Johnson came in late in the game, carried it 9 times for 35. Martell Williams, 7 carries for 23. Matt Crable, the quarterback, carried it 6 times for 19. Eli Wallace, a few carries as well, 5 for 10 yards and a score. A lot of Cougars caught passes today. Dan Riske, Rocky James at the top of the list. They were at the top of the list last season. Rixey, 5 for 63. James, 4 for 64 and 2 touchdowns. Jordan Schmeling at 4 for 44. Mike Kolenkevich, 2 catches for 2 touchdowns. Will Chrisman, 2 catches for 35 yards and a score before he went out with an injury. Casey Cole had a pair of catches for 30 and a touchdown as well. Duke Blackwell, back from his injury, missed all of last season after tearing an ACL in the championship game 2 years ago, had a catch for 35 yards. That was a score. Dylan Huntley and Delvin Green also had catches in the ball game. St. Francis, Indiana, 469 yards of total offense, 340 through the air, 129 on the ground. No turnovers for the Cougars. The Saints mustered just 260 yards of total offense, 150 on the ground, 110 through the air, 14 first downs, but they committed 6 penalties for 67 yards and turned it over 3 times. Next game for the Cougars. They are on the road back into this area, back to Illinois to take on Robert Morris. They've won 20 games in a row against Illinois teams. They're going to go for 21 against the Eagles of Robert Morris next week. The Saints, well, finally going to play a team that is not ranked in the top three. They're going to take on Trinity International up in Deerfield next week. That is a 1 o'clock kickoff, which you can listen to live on WCSF 88.7. On the radio dial here in Joliet, just Google WCSF. It'll take you to the website where you can listen live online as well. Saints fall to 0-2 against 2 of the best teams in the country today, 56-6 on their home opener. For Lee Turnbow, who's not here, but I hope he feels better, for the entire TV crew, Brandon and Jessica and everybody else, we appreciate all your hard work. I'm not sure how many more nice days we're going to get, so I hope you guys enjoyed this one outside as well. My name's Nick. We'll see you next week up in Deerfield. Thanks for listening to Saints Football on the USF Sports TV Network.